Howdy! My name is Haley, and I'm an engineering student at the University of Colorado Boulder studying creative technology and design. In today's lesson, we're first going to brainstorm about what plants need to grow and survive. Then, we'll follow in engineers' footsteps by planning a scientific experiment we can perform in the classroom to test if our ideas are correct. That sound like fun? Let's grow! I mean, go! Before we explore the needs of plants, let's first think about what us humans need to survive. Well, we all know that we need food to eat, water to drink, air to breathe, and a shelter to sleep in and stay warm. You might have a pet at home, such as a dog or cat. Do they need the same things as us to survive? Yes, we all share the same core needs, except that we don't eat the same food as them. Yuck. Now, back to plants. Do you think they need the same things that us and our pets do? Think about it this way. Do all plants have a home they live in and eat breakfast, lunch, and dinner every day? Do they sleep at night too? Of course not, that would be so silly. However, we do know that plants need some of the same things we and other animals do through observation. For example, if you have a front yard with grass and flowers, you know that it needs to be watered every day or so. Or if you have a plant somewhere in your house, you know that it needs to be placed next to a window in order for it to look happy and not wilt. Maybe you've also noticed that a great majority of plants are planted in soil. So what does this all mean? How can we be sure that plants need water, sun, and soil to survive and grow? Through an experiment, of course. An experiment is a test that engineers and scientists do to see whether their idea is correct. While experiments have many different types, the one we'll focus on today is a controlled experiment. In a controlled experiment, we make sure everything stays the same except for one specific difference, which is called a variable. The reason why we test this single change is to determine whether it's the cause of the experiment's result. Now that we're experiment experts, let's think about how to test if plants really need water, sun, and soil to survive. What if we put a plant in the dark, took away its soil, and didn't water it? Would that work? No, of course not. That would be testing everything at the same time, and we wouldn't know which thing caused the plant to change. Remember, water, sun, and soil are variables, and are all separate things to test. First, let's set up our water experiment. We'll start with two plants with equal soil amounts in the same sunny spot in our classroom. One plant will get watered every day, and the other plant won't get any water. After a week, we can measure the difference in growth between the two plants and make a conclusion from there. Next, for our sun experiment, let's start again with two plants, but this time with the same amount of soil and water. Now, instead of keeping them in the same location, we'll put one plant where sunlight can't reach, such as a drawer or cabinet. Don't forget about it, though. From there, we can observe the changes between the plants after 1 week. Finally, for our soil experiment, let's have two plants with the same sunny location and watering schedule. This time, we'll take away the soil from one of the plants. After a week, we can compare the results. By testing one variable at a time through these three controlled experiments, we'll figure out exactly what plants need to survive. Now that we've thought through these three experiments, it's time to set them up in the real world. Make sure to write down your observations each day and record any changes you see. Also, be sure to use a ruler for measurements so you can track the growth of your plants. If you perform the experiments correctly by following all of these steps, you should be able to make a conclusion based off of your results. Engineers use experiments all the time because they are an excellent way to test out theories and find conclusions to share with the world. An example of a famous engineering experiment in history is Thomas Edison's light bulb. Edison tested thousands of materials, from coconut hairs to fishing lines, before inventing the long-lasting light bulb made of carbonized cotton thread. This experiment is an important lesson as to why you should never give up when you have a goal in mind. One more famous engineering experiment is the Wright brothers' first flight. the brothers worked tirelessly to get the first airplane to fly all the way back in 1903. Do you have any other experiments that you want to try in the future? I hope you stay curious about the world around you, just like engineers do. Check out the full lesson on the Teach Engineering website. Then, continue on with this experiment in your classroom by following our associated activity: light plants and dark plants, wet plants and dry ones.